Hey mate, I'm Alex.
And I'm Gaston.
Welcome to Power Mate.
This is the place to learn and share about Powerbrick and Power Platform. If this is your first time here, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this channel with your friends and colleagues.
So, welcome again, Power Mate. Today, we are going to dive into the world of Microsoft Fabric Domain. So stay with us as we guide you through on why domains are so important in Microsoft Fabric. So let's ask our Fabric wizard today, Gaston, please enlighten us on what are Microsoft Fabric domains.
Yeah, right on, Alex. Let's start with the concept behind domains in Microsoft Fabric, because this is the way that we have to structure the data, your organizational data, based on your business needs. So you can adjust that and personalize that based on what we've been working and discussing in terms of overall the data across the organization. So you can define also domain ownership, federate the governance layer, checking on the granular control and access to all the artifacts, and provide infrastructure to start treating your data as a product. So let's go and share my screen and talk about this concept on the domains field.
Yeah, got you.
As you can see, there's four pillars within domains in Fabric, where you can start right away with the domain creation and the definition, assigning the domain admins, the domain contributors, and also it's kind of a best practice to assign a domain image. So when the business users are going to be accessing all your data in your domain, if you can relate the image with your domain, it's going to be easier for them to find all the artifacts that belongs to that domain. The other concept is the workspace association, and that is kind of a, you can start adding multiple workspace that belongs to the same domain. The other big concept around the security, you can define the workspace association by workspace admin, and you can assign also to your domain by capacities within your tenant. Another big concept, the federated governance. You know, you can define who is going to be, and the main goal of who is going to be an ID group that you can assign as an admin to manage the whole content of your domain. And at the same point, giving granular access to each of the artifacts per domain. Last concept on those pillars is you can and you are going to be able to give your business the option to find quickly all the data that belongs to each domain via the data hub and the compact view. Also, if you relate the image of your domain, that is going to be easier to find all the artifacts. And at the same point, the domain's indications as a next step to the workspace consumption experience.
Okay, yeah. Now we have pretty much clear the idea on what domains means. So what is the process to set up a new domain? Could you guide us, you know, step by step on how to?
Yeah, let's go again to my screen and I can share the step-by-step process. So first of all, as you can see, the very first step is going to your settings, the admin portal, and then you can enable the domains. As you can see, you can create your domain, defining the name, defining a description of your domain. That could be finance, marketing, sales, and so on. Then you are going to be defining your domain image that you can relate to each domain, and you can pick some images to identify in some way your domain. The last step or the next step is defining your domain admins. That could be an email of person or an AD group that you're going to be associated as a domain admin. Next step, define the contributors for your domain. And the last one is assigning workspace that you can assign by name, by workspace admin, or by capacity. Remember that you can assign multiple workspace to the same domain.
That's awesome. So now we know, okay, what domains means, how to set up those domains. So the last question is, what is then best way to find the artifact that belong to your particular domains?
Yeah, right away, you can go to the One Lake Data Hub. Let me go back to my screen. And you can define in the One Lake Data Hub as an option to quickly search for your artifacts within your domain. As you can see in the left pane, I am clicking the Data Hub. Then I am clicking the One Lake Data Hub. I am filtering the data by the domain. That could be finance, operations, marketing, sales, and I can see all the artifacts that belongs to each of those domains. But I am also having at the right of my screen one of the options to filter by keyword. So if you see all the artifacts that belongs to that domain, you can also filter one of the artifacts or some of the artifacts, let's say data sets or lakehouse or data warehouse, that belongs to each of that domain.
Great. So now we can find the artifact and see how the artifacts are tagged. All right, PowerMate, that wraps up today's episode. We hope you are as excited as we are about the potential of Microsoft Fabric, the workloads and the component, and of course, Power Platform.
Stay tuned, because in our next episode, we will be moving forward again with Microsoft Fabric, this time with shortcuts.
Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, hit that notification bell, and join us on this journey.
Together, let's unlock the full potential on Microsoft Fabric and Power Platform.
See ya.